time, July 1966. The place, the Royal Agricultural Show, where Ford Tractor Operations presented the only bloodless bullfight in the world. A stirring mechanical contest demonstrating the outstandingness of Ford tractors. Circling the ring in the Grand Parade, which is the traditional opening to all bullfights, are the daring Toreadors, represented by the Ford 3000, the Ford 4000, and Ford 5000 tractors. And now, the Brave Bull, the latest Ford selector speed radio-controlled tractor, developed by some of the best computer brains in Britain. The new Ford radio tractor can be controlled by radio or cable at a range of up to half a mile, and can do virtually everything a mounted tractor can do. The bull will now be played by two matadors on foot, the peones. In a real bullfight, this is done to test the bull's reactions and to take the edge off his brute energy. But of course, our bull's energy goes on for as long as there's fuel in his tank. Look at that for accuracy. Radio controlled accuracy. 100 yards away. Turn your back on the bull, least of all on a Ford radio control type. Now it's the turn of the picadors, who goad the bull from horseback, planting banderillos or darts in his shoulders. Our first picador is mounted on a Ford 3000, fitted with a chopper blower for harvest work. Chopper blowers aren't permitted in a proper bull ring, but, well, they're mighty handy on the farm. Here's the gallant leading matador to demonstrate some tricky cape work on a 56 horsepower Ford 4000 tractor and loader. For the real life aficionados, the true bullfight fans, this is the star turn of the afternoon, when the leading toreros demonstrate all their skill and courage. Control system has 28 working channels, 550 diodes, 750 resistors, 250 transistors, 250 capacitors, and it works. Our mechanical torero isn't doing so badly either, but since the lifting capacity on the 4000 is about 1.5 tons and it offers featherlight control, handling a cape is child's play. Standard on all four tractors, fully independent hydraulics give hydraulic power whenever the engine is running. There's further work on the bull by the Ford 5000 67 horsepower tractor, aided by the handy workmanlike Ford 3000. The giant 5000 is fitted with selector speed transmission. That dial on the bonnet shows you which of the 10 forward or 2 reverse gears the driver's using. Look how maneuverable this great tractor is with the selector speed system. The driver can change in or out of any of the gears while on the move, giving an immense speed up to loader shuttle work and all other farming operations. Now for the moment of truth, the face-to-face killing of the bull. Well, that can happen to the best of bullfighters. A case of modesty being the better part of valor. But how are we to get Ferdinand Ford out of the arena, short of bribing the operator? Here's the answer. An attractive young heifer. The Ford 2000 made of all work in the tractor field. Vital statistics, 37 horsepower, 6 forward and 2 reverse speeds, and fully independent hydraulics. Ready, willing, and able. She'll go anywhere, do anything, except the washing up. Nice bodywork, too. Our bull thinks so, anyway. Death enthusiastic. In fact, he's showing his swing-out battery, specially designed for easier maintenance. Miss Ford 2000 clearly has him by the horns. Well, you don't need to be a tough, radio-controlled bull to fall for that number. There he goes, twiddling his power takeoff tail. Now, we can go one better than the real thing and bring them all back to take a bow. Here's our bull and his handsome 2,000 lady friend. They seem to have produced a calf already. That's the new 10-horsepower Ford baby from the United States, the very latest model for the keen American gardener. And as they all go round in the final parade, we'll say adios y hasta la vista, or as Ford say, we'll be there whenever and wherever there's tractor work to be done.